Today I'm going to talk about the technology development model in designing futures technologies, societies, concepts, whatever you can think of. And I'd like to bring actually the European perspective. My name is Gulay Ozkan. I'm founder of Get Design Consultancy based in Istanbul. Exactly 10 years ago, I started my company, my design consultancy company, mainly to fix the problems in technology development. Because today, I mean, the technology, you know, it's very attractive because it's scalable. It also brings a lot of financial attractiveness. But at the same time, if there's a problem, then the problem is big. No need to mention Facebook right here. But the judiciary is a very interesting example. You know, it received $120 million from companies like Google Ventures. It's basically a juice making machine that wanted to transform the world. But what happened, Bloomberg journalists figured that out, that you can actually squeeze these packs, you don't need this machine. So after that, the company was bankrupt. So we need to change the way that we approach technology. Today, the approach is, okay, I have an idea, I want to develop this technology, and then let's validate it. But the result is, as many as 95% of products and services introduced each year fail. So we need to change that. The change is, we need to focus on the problem. We need to understand the human needs, human desires, and then based on the data, we need to build data-driven ideas. Material Life is a project funded by the European Commission under Horizon 2020 program. There are 20 companies, including mine. We aim to develop smart products for older people to make their life more independent and fashionable. And these 20 companies coming from 9 countries, the project will take 3 years. It's a pretty long project. These 20 companies, we are organized under 6 dimensions of technology development. Let's say some associations of older people, they take care of ethics, user recruitment. My company is leading design. There are also 3 other product design companies in Europe, in different countries. And then data protection, of course, GDPR is enforced by European Union, so it's a must. And also technology companies. But the most important thing, this project is user-driven project. So our users are in the center. This is super crucial. We start the project with user recruitment, but the most important thing, we didn't pay any agencies. We asked these older associations of older people. These associations help us to find these people in 9 countries. And first, in 6 countries, we talk to these people. We understand their lives. We understand their problems. And based on that data, we build some initial design direction and some initial ideas. Then we brought these ideas to 9 countries and run 10 co-creation workshops together with these older people. We developed the ideas further. We developed the products further. So we developed the ideas by them. They are our co-designers in 9 countries. Right now, we are designing concept prototypes. We just passed the design freeze, which means that the design companies led by my company, we are handovering the project, the products, to the technology teams. So how we are going to make sure that the next 2 years, this human data, this user centricity is not getting lost among the partners, technology partners, who are not familiar with user centricity and human data. So this is a design management problem, this is a design management issue. But we address this problem by introducing service design labs. This is a tool that allows you to align all the components, all the partners around the user data, which is a very helpful tool that will help us to make sure that the project still is user-focused. So this is, again, a user-driven innovation project that I'm quite proud of to present. These are my contact details. Please keep in touch through LinkedIn as well. Thank you.